Hello everybody, once again, this is Akawakazu, and welcome back to COS 1 semi-finals here in Westwood. We have Team Zero going up against Sweet Slava J, and I don't think I still pronounced that team name correctly, but maybe in this video you can leave behind in the comments, let me know what's the correct pronunciation. Right now, Team Zero, led by Time Lord, also playing as Cranberry, is a shooting star, or I think it's a shooting star, if I'm not wrong, or it's a Gear Master. No, it's a shooting star. Smooth Shocker, Destroyer, Ice Lord, Elestra, Architect, Guardian, and a Gazer Sniper, and you'll be going up against Sweet Slava J. Spirit Cross Guardian, OE 35 Destroyer, Miko 28 Tempers, Sweet Ness Elestra, and Lolly Adept. And it seems like they're finished loading right now. You can see their team lineups right now. Who's gonna be the first player? You can see OE 35 say, let's go. Seems like Cranberry, which is the shooting star, played by Time Lord, will be going against OE 35, based on Stunning Grenade. Gets a nice rocket jump here to the ping pong here. Nice plays. Even the air shot a bit of air evasion. Well placed gravity grenade here by the Demolition Fist. Bomb used well. Bubble to the face. Since that Time Lord is proving that shooting stars. So Gear Master, look at it. Splash to the face. 57% HP left. Even a nice air shot to catch the Ice Bomb Tower raining on him. Forces the relief. And the Crisis Howl here. The Maelstrom Howl. No flash grenade here. But air evasion timing here is good to air bomb there. It's by an important time. And Flying Swings bomb used well from OE35 there to prevent the Biochemical Missile. Biochemical Missile took away, Bravano is caught by a whirlwind, but Alfredo Beam there on OE35 is down 28% HP. Rocket Jump Finch is good, but Alfredo's grabbing the grenade, Alfredo Hurricane's on him, he's getting caught by the Bubble Ball as well, and my goodness! OE35 taken away by a shooting star. An engineer class that everybody thought had no more hope, and mind you, Destroyer is one of the hardest matchups a Gear Master or shooting star has to watch out for, and this is why this is the semi-finals here. I believe Time Lord has done lots of training here to be able to tackle OE35 there. It was definitely awesome right from the first round. And we have seen Miko right now, and Spirit Cross has left the game, so we can see the HP before we actually disconnect the game to restart it. But right now, flash grenade timing is good, but Sakun kick iframe used well from Miko himself. 28% HP, avoids the splash to the face, gets caught by air bomb here. Hurricane Dance Avoider, he buys time, but he's still caught, and I believe Miko still has 100% HP, and I'm gonna stop the match right here. So right now we are back due to disruption. Spirit Cross disconnected just now in our game 1. So right now OE35 was taken away by Cranberry, also known as Time Lord, in extremely, I would say, unexpected fashion. It was brilliant play from him from all over the place, even with the ping pong damage nerf. He managed to do everything he can to take away OE35, it was just brilliant from Time Lord previously. Very good bubbles, very good splashes, and very good re-catching as well. Even though the Maelstrom Howl connected and the Whirlwind as well, it was not enough to take away Time Lord here. Even though it took quite a bit of damage there, so OE35 didn't quite do badly, but Time Lord just having that 1-up in that face-off. And that was definitely unexpected for an engineer after the tower HP nerfs and the ping pong damage nerfs, and he's a shooting star. So there's no Mechadark iframe, and Mechadark iframe for Game Masters is removed as well. But Miko went on to take away Time Lord with 100% HP left. In fact, I think he had 98% HP. But you recover 10% HP whenever you win a game. So Miko essentially has 100% HP, and he's just gonna take away Time Lord here, and then the match will continue for Game 1. Usually one Spiral Vortex will have taken away the engineer, but I can see the 50% damage nerf for Tempest is definitely significant here. But right now, the game is coming back in game 1 right now. Zero versus Sweet Slava J. We had a very epic start, but unfortunately Spirit Cross disconnected and the momentum is halted there. But right now, it seems like Ice Lord will be going up against the Tempest, which is a good choice definitely. I think Elestra is definitely very hard to deal with as a Tempest, especially after the damage nerf. Previously, you could actually go for the DPS race to see who burn more HP, even with the Ice Shield on. But right now, you can't because the damage is nerfed, so you need to dodge. You dodge the Frost Wind. Gets caught by the Freezing Sauce on the tip, even though the Kickshot iframe was used. But it's the Freezing Field with second kick iframe, Miko is playing well so far. Gets caught by Frostwind here, to a Glacial Wave and the Phoenix Storm once again. Oh my goodness, there's a crit on one of those Phoenix Storms there. It was 14,000 damage, and look at that, Miko's already down with 60% HP, and taken away by the Freezing Swords here. Gets a lag at that moment there when he was caught, and didn't expect that Glacial Wave to catch him. I didn't expect that Glacial Wave to relieve the target again to freeze him, but apparently that happened, and a lucky crit off the Phoenix Storm there. 4.5k times 2 plus 6.4k on the crit. And it seems like the Guardian Spirit Cross will be going up. Wise choice as well from Sweet Slava J with the Elemental Aura. a question is, patterns or guidance are actually quite susceptible to the less stress as well, because the lucky block of the Frostwind, Shinbreaker avoided, gets caught by Shockwave to Flame Spark Flinch and a Glacier Wave once again, a Flink Storm. No crits this time, gets caught by Justice Clash Electric Smite combo here. He's losing 40% HP. Nice Holy Bolt continuation from Spirit Cross to get the Electric Smite, no, the Lightning Zip as well. That will definitely take more HP away from Ice Lord. Not much, but about 10%, maybe 5%. But right now, Spirit Cross bought enough time for that important Divine Avatar very soon. He used back 86% HP, is doing well. Textbook playstyle, definitely. Avoids the Glacier Wave nicely. Oh, Stance of Faith cancelled there. It's frozen. Oh, it's taking a lot of damage. Forces the Divine Avatar here. I think he should have used it earlier on to prevent the HP being lost, but right now he has lost more HP than he needed to do. And Ice Lord there knows that right now he just needs to do enough damage to Spirit Cross. But he gets caught by a well-timed Justice Crash there. I think that was unexpected from Ice Lord himself. And Ice Lord is taken away back to a 3v3 situation, but mind you, Spirit Cross is already down to about 55% HP after the recovering of 10% HP from winning. And we see a Gazer coming up next. The Sniper, very hard to deal with, definitely. We've seen him play extremely well since the start of this tournament. Look at that, a Twin Shot going there at far range. Even without Seals, it with the Longbow Mastery, increase the range. Our range is still very far. You can know a Gazer knows his range very well. Shield Charge is going to be used. Electric Smart Iron Frame, I don't think that was a wise choice. Shield Charge should be used, gets a 10,000 crit on the Charge Shot there. Spirit Cross is down 20% HP. The block is used, Trading Point placed in offensive position. Our Gazer knows he has the advantage right now. He doesn't know how much HP that Spirit Cross has lost in his match against Ice Lord previously. But he knows it could be quite a bit due to the Glacier Wave and Freezing Swords if he was paying attention. He heals back 31% HP, forces the Sons of Faith. Buying time for the Divine Vata, and then that's when Spirit Cross will make his attack. Tracking Arrows is out, well timed here, but Iron Will used in response. Garden Force as well, look at that, only 300 damage taken there, but he's down to a lot of damage. Arrow Brush will be used in the follow up here. Indeed, Arrow Brush is used, doesn't get time to use the Divine Vata. Oh, he gets a time there, as Agazer was not quite accurate on his Arrow Barrage there, unfortunately. He's not to get caught by Lightning Zap. Dive Kick to bait the Fake Shot there, Justice Crash jump, blaze his tumble. Every chain shot! Oh, I think he wanted to use Triangle Shot there, he's caught by the Justice Crash, Electric Smite combo once again. Spirit Cross does well here. But Gazer not letting up so far, he still has the advantage, the block is up for Spirit Cross once again. Tracking Arrows is out to take away the block counters, Gazer knows this is the press advantage, is pushing through. Cheating Point plays to trap him. Nope, not really, he's actually in a offensive, defensive position. 20% HP left right now. And mind you, Tracking Arrows, cooldown has been increased, so you can't really expect the Tracking Arrows to come very soon. Spirit Cross is playing very well here, 38% HP left, buying that time here, once again with Stance of Faith. I think he has his Electric Smite and Justice Crash right now, he's trying to cut the range here. Okay, he's not biting on the Holy Relic bait. Tracking Arrows is up, but look at that, Iron View once again is up. No Garden Force this time, Charge Shot continuation is good, 6k there! Stunning Arrow avoided. 38% HP, needs to be careful of the shield charge of Justice Crash. He baits the urgency trick, Electric Smite dodged and cancelled there by Gazer, he knows it was coming. Desperate moments for Spirit Cross here and down to about 45 seconds left on the clock. Oh, the Anchor Shot connects here. But the Divine Vengeance here, no, Divine Punishment, the Reflect damage is on. Dragon was about the Triangle Shot. Justice Crash, bomb used well by Arrow Brush continuation. If Gazer does it, ticks away Spirit Cross here. But I believe Spirit Cross has done the damage despite having such a low HP pool at the start. And swiftly says, Gazer, I support you too. But it's a 2v3 situation right now. And it's Adept Illestra against a Sniper, Destroyer and a Guardian. I would say that in terms of class composition, it's definitely leaning towards Team Zero for the advantage. As I believe OE35 was not meant to take away the Shooting Star here, so Time Lord does well to take away OE35. Which was definitely one of the crucial moments. Oh, nice stunning arrow here from Agazer himself to get the Anchor Shot. The Tracking Arrows just come up. Nice Charge Shot to the face. Kills the Ice Pump Tower. Nice Magma Wave here, but the Tracking Arrows hits on Lolly Adept as well. I mean Lolly Adept. It goes in. Ice Beam connects! Oh, what a nice Ice Beam here. Crucial to bring back to a 2v2 situation against a Destroyer and Guardian, and I think Team Zero will bring up their Guardian instead of Smoochie. They're gonna leave Smoochie to be the goalkeeper. Nope, it seems like Smoochie. Nope, Architect. Seems like Time Lord has the same thinking as me. Because of the Elemental Aura, I'll be safer against the Adept here. And they know that their depth is definitely low. He baits the armor break here. Buys time for the wax, definitely important for Lolly Tap here. Definitely very good adept right now. Bubble Bubble Father with a nice Shinbreaker. And my wave is good. But Lucky Tech avoided that one. Look at that, no elemental aura at all. Gets a cocktail, but no, that Ice Girl expression is no longer a viable one-hit skill. Playstyle. It's called by Shinbreaker here. Justice Crash and it's taken away. Lolly Dab lagged at the wrong moment there. 1v2 situation here. As it's up to Sweet Nest, the Illestra, to try and bring this back. It is definitely possible. Illestra is definitely very versatile in facing any class. But against a Paladin, you need to play a perfect, possibly perfect play here. With Architect at 100% HP, you will need a perfect play. But Architect, I would say, is a very passive counter player. He's not gonna go in strong. He's gonna wait for you to come. Gets caught by a Lucky Ice Shield Freeze there. It is fixed right now. Gets caught by Shockwave as well. Holy Bolt avoided there. Gets a Lucky Block. Glacier Wave avoided with Shinbreaker here. Firewall Spawn used well to cancel the Justice Crash. Good plays. Icy Step good as well. Electric Spike connects here. As the block is up for Architect, look at that. He's down to 54% HP. He's in trouble right now. Ice Spear is good to Chilling Mist. Oh my goodness. But not quite a lot of damage there. The Freezing Fear avoided as well. Garden Force used. You can see Sweetness trying to go in to make use of that Lestra Ice Cage to freeze him because it was broken. But I didn't quite get the lucky freeze there. Divine Battle Force. Right now, Sweetness on the run. He needs to watch for his mana. Gets caught by a Lightning Zap. No, he doesn't. Blinks timely here to avoid that. Gets caught by Justice Crash, I believe. But no stun here as he was jumping. Psychic Holy Kick is good to Electric Smite. Architect does well. Holy Bolt, well placed. Sweetness down 20% HP. It's not over just yet. Freezing Swords avoided here with the block once again. Stunts of Faith is stacked. Fire Vortex is good. But it's just out of range there, even though it's quite cornered. Architect the gun here, gets his Freezing Shield on once again. I think it's going to be tough. Glacier Wave is good. 8% HP left for Architect. He's going to be taken away. Shockwave avoided here. Lightning Zap connects. Needs to take away Architect right now. He takes away Architect. 20% HP left and 70% MP left for Sweetness. He's going to be going up against Blue Shocker. I don't know. Let's say when ESD took away Feeble Me that time. Is it Feeble Me? I think so. Yeah, I think so from Vengeance X. He actually used around 20% MP as well or lesser. But that's because Feeble Me made some mistakes there. And I think for me, if I'm Sweetness, I'm going to go for the R in here. You know, Smooth Shocker has HP. Based Air Evasion. Frostwind avoided. Good for Smooth Shocker. Look, he already lost 25% HP here. Taunting on a bit, the Power Blink. And a Circle Swing. 1-0 to Team Zero right now as they go into game number 2. So welcome back to game number 2. I'll say it's extremely close here, down to the last member for both teams, Team Zero against Sweet Slava J here. But right now with the Tempest, Miko 28 going up against a Gazer the Sniper, I'll say it can go either way. I went to try Tempest PvP myself, but right now Miko having the advantage here. I think the Urgent Surge is better, Triangle Shot is good, Circle Shot used to try and maneuver out of it. Eagle Dive is good to catch a Gazer here, the Spiral Vortex here, doesn't get the Cyclone Kick continuation. Kick Shot! Gonna see the Hurricane Dance, possibly off this. Yeah, it's Hurricane Dance off this. Against it in trouble right now. Gets away, Switcher iframe, countered. With Kick Shot iframe as well, he's gonna be taken away. Against it, the Sniper, could it be? Willow Kick. Oh, Air Evasion timing here is good. But we know Miko's on the chase, Triangle Shot baited, Circle Shot used to counter there. He gets caught by a Charge Shot himself. Against it on the counter attack right now. Cancels the Tracking Arrows there with Booming Kick. And he's taken away. Sweet Slava J on the counter attempt right now as a Gazer, one of their most prized members, has been taken away. And I'm not too sure if we have time for game number 3, as the Net Cafe has a curfew of 12 AM or midnight. Not too sure if it's gonna give, are they gonna give any leeway to these players from Philippines? But Ice Lord right now is coming up next for Team Zero. Avoids the Freezing Swords this time. Miko not getting caught by the Glacial Wave as well. Gets caught by the Freezing Field due to lag. Oh my goodness, unfortunate for Miko. He definitely dodged that one. Flame Spark is good for Ice Lord. Doesn't get a knockdown. Oh, nice timing here to connect here once again for Miko. He was going to be caught by the Ignite there, even though he was caught with his Tumble baited. But he went in strong. It's caught by the Freezing Swords once again. 29% HP left. Ice slot 69%. Here's the Ice Cage on. You can see Miko trying to take away the Ice Cage with damage here. Spirit Shot takes it away. He bases the tumble there, Sakun Kick iframe used. You can see Ice Slot is just baiting those skills right now. Cancelled by Freezing Swords once again. Fire Vortex uses a counter, he takes 50% less damage here, so you can see that the skill didn't do quite a lot of damage. But you can see Ice Slot is already down to 29% MP, but he still took away Miko here, but I would say Miko has done well. I'm not too sure, are they going to be sending Spirit Cross against this Illustra? And it's true, Miko, it is lagging for you, I agree. Unfortunate for you. But I would say Ice Slot played well as well to beat some of his skills. Well, we have Spirit Cross. Pretty good player so far as we have seen. Gets the Elemental Aura up. Gets away from Freezing Swords in time with his Shield Charge. Once again, he's buying time for that rotation of defensive buffs here. Justice Crush iframe used well, but he was slowed, so he's easily dodges the Freezing Field as well. Electric Spine iframe used in anticipation of Ice Slot coming in with the Frostwind, but Ice Slot doesn't bite the bait. You can see Ice Slot switched off his shield right now because he knows that Spirit Cross, most damaging skills are over, but he gets caught by Lightning Zap here. He's gonna get his shield back up. Is he gonna be taking his shield back up? Look at Spirit Cross, it doesn't give any qualms about the Lightning Zap hitting because he knows he's just gonna be waiting for the Divine Vata to catch him once again. Gets caught by Frostwind here. Divine Vata timing is good. So the Ice Cage shoots in response. He jumps. Kind of forces as well to take away the Ice Cage, but no shield for Ice Lord, and he's taken away straight away. So I don't know, Spirit Cross is some mind reader here. His Justice Crash was like, I'm trying to bait you, but I'm not trying to bait you. So he took that chance there, and it took away Ice Lord. So 4v3 situation right now. His Spirit Cross very healthy here, and it seems like the Shooting Star Time Lord will be going up next, and this will be an interesting matchup here. Bonk EX avoided. You can see Time Lord just trying to press the advantage to corner him. Electric Smite avoided here. Just be careful with Justice Crash nevertheless, but you know Spirit Cross is just poking fun at the moment. He's just waiting and buying time for the Divine Baton once again. And before that, my own game plan against Gear Masters was to wait for Divine Master as well. But the Alfredo transition damage is up for Time Lord right now. Forces the Stance of Faith, please be careful, the Alfredo Beam tears through as well, and Alfredo Beam will be on cooldown. So it's a good thing for Spirit Cross. He was back to 98% HP, he's still good as new. It's caught by a knockdown off the cannon, good stuff. Bubble connects once again for Time Lord, the splash as well, down to 60% HP. Doesn't get the Rocket Jump relief, Biochemical Missile is good, but forces the Divine Vata here. Oh, the Skyline is used as well, he jumps. Gets caught by a Justice Crash. But Alfredo transition damage, that was the last second there for the Alfredo transition damage for Time Lord. He was fortunate there. The Justice Crash only doing 4k, I think 5,000 damage there, it was 4.9k. Alfredo Beam once again dodged. Cancels the Shield Charge there nicely with the Cannon Shots. So Time Lord definitely holding his own right now as a Shooting Star. Gadget Grenade well placed. Oh nice, nasty heavy here, that's the Black Hole, Laser Black Hole. Ping Pong to the face as well, but the IMV used in time, avoids the bubble. I think they might be playing for HP here, 1 minute left on the clock right now. Once again, Alfredo transition damage is up, reduced damage for Time Lord. Nice ping pong to the face, Biochemical Missile is good on the wake attack, he's caught. Alfredo Beam avoided thankfully for Spirit Cross. I think he's buying time for the last Divine Vata, because he knows just one Justice Crash. Chainbreaker is avoided. And Cranberry knows, Time Lord knows, he cancels the Shield Charge there, it's good. Doesn't get caught by the Lightning Zap. Vex is good, he's caught by the Justice Crash, please be careful, he avoids the Electric Smite. Ping Pong to the face is good, forces the Stance of Faith, and the Bubble Ball connects, cancels the Stance of Faith. The Splash is gonna be coming to his face, Splash, 9% HP left, 5%, 0%, gets a lucky block here, but it's gonna be taken away. One more Cannon Shot from Time Lord. Doesn't get a triple shot here, the last Divine Vata is forced. Time Lord on the run, Spirit Cross, 0% HP left, he is jumping. Afro Beam tearing through, but no, Divine Butter is on, he's jumping. Gets the wax speed burst, I mean the speed boost. 3 seconds left, 2 seconds left on Divine Butter, he's gonna heal back in time. Dive kick used. Time Lord doesn't know he has 0% HP. Time Lord just one more cannon shot here, but Time Lord is playing for the time as well. But no, Time Lord didn't get to kill him. Nevertheless, he won by more HP, and he'll only find out when watching this video that Spirit Cross only had 0% HP left. And this will be the turnaround, because you can see right now there's a Destroyer, Lestra, and Adept left. We have a Shooting Star Destroyer and a Guardian left. So once again, the advantage I would say will be tearing towards Team Zero. You'll be up to Time Lord to take away OE 35 again, and if you can, I would say you will definitely be leaning towards Team Zero to win this 2-0. So it's up to OE 35 to perform here. Sekusung is good, Mr. Hall timing is Boilo to get that. That's a perfect air evasion to airdrop here for Time Lord to avoid that Maelstrom Hall, but Iron Skin is going to be a problem. Wax is good. Biochemical Cell, Voider, it was a defensive one. Alfredo Beam with Voider as well. Gets caught by the Ring Bombs here, but Alfredo transition is up. But I think it's going to be hard, but look at that. The Alfredo Hurricane is whacking on OE35 right now. 5% HP left. Your voice and base the crisis. How about the Cyclone X is out? Nicely done by OE35. This time, not giving Time Lord a chance at all. Tearing through all the skills that he needs to use to tear away this Shooting Star. 3v2 situation right now. And I would say it's up to Smooth Shocker once again to make this count, because Architect can be used to fight against Sweetness, and if Smooth Shocker can take away OE35 fast and furious style, Team Zero will have a good chance once again. But don't count OE35 out just yet. To get an impact punch to the face on the dash blow, and if I'm not wrong, Smooth Shocker is actually sick today. Oh, Smooth Shocker flying swings earlier based air evasion. Circle Swing is good as OE35 tumbles too soon. Maelstrom Hall, 62% HP left. Hasn't forced a relief just yet. Forced a relief by impact punch to the face, and a woman is out. Seems like OE35 could be taken away here. Look at that, taunting out to relieve the target once again. Good plays from Smooth Shocker. Area evasion timing here is good. Gets caught by Circle Swing as well. It's OE35's counter attack right now. It's gonna be a Cyclone X after a whirlwind. No, he gets out after relief. His own Cyclone X is out first. OE35 in trouble right now, because the Maelstrom Hall is gonna be used after this. No, he's taken away by Smooth Shocker once again. So whether there's a game tree or not, it's up to Sweetness and Lollydep right now. And I know Lollydep's gonna be going up next. Or is it Sweetness? It seems like it's gonna be Sweetness. But Smooth Shocker once again, very very tough to deal with. He's a veteran in terms of pressure taking, in terms of tournaments, this is the man to watch. Some of the most consistent players I've watched so far. Gets caught by Frostwind so far, flinch. Avoids the Glacier Wave, thankfully. Circle Swing is good, but gets cancelled by Shockwave. Good plays from Sweetness right now. The Freezing Field tearing through. 20% HP left for Smooth Shocker right now. He gets caught an Icy Step as well. Gets the buff on. Uses the Whirlwind right away. But he's down to 0% HP. He's taken away by Sweetness. It seems like Game 3 is imminent here. Or will Architect stop this Rampage? I don't know. I really don't know. I would say it's 50-50 chance here. Architect definitely a very good Guardian. Ice Lord has left. Not too sure, maybe when he restarts his comm or something. But it's up to Architect here. Shinbroken and Armor Break is good. It gets caught by 10,000 damage. Freezing Swords here. He backs away. Gets caught by Flame Spark. Gets caught by Freezing Fury as well. But a nice Holy Bolt to Justice Crash. 16,000 is a crit, and the Electric Smite going through. 14,000 left for Sweetness, and he's caught by a Lightning Zap as well. Gets the block out in time. I think Architect will want to heal first. Sharp Shot tearing through. 2% HP left for Sweetness. Avoids the Ice Sphere, thankfully. Gets lucky block off the Freezing Swords. Architect doesn't know Sweetness has 2% HP. He heals back. Because of my Poison Spray right now. Shinbreaker to safety. Divine Butter is gonna kill Sweetness. No, the Ice Cage saves him. It's jumping. Armor Break Avoider with a nice Bling. Electric Smite Avoider as well. Justice Crash after baiting a Bling. No, it's Avoider as well. Sweetness, 2% HP and fighting. But sadly for Elestras, you can't really heal. It's gonna be killed by the Divine Punishment. Architect's playing it safe. Avoids the Fiery Vortex here. It's actually caught. It's at the edge here. The next Freezing Sword is going to be coming through. First the Glacial Wave, Armor Break avoided. She charges to chase Sweetness. He blinks away in time. Nice ice spear here. That keeps my ice beam used well against, but he's frozen there. It seems like Akira might be taken away here. 1% HP, no, the laser black hole. 0% HP left. But he's slow to a halt. It's got my fireball. No, Architect takes Sweetness away here. It's gonna be a 1v1 situation. And it's up to Lollydab to do the burst damage on Architect. Can he do it? That's the big question here to push it to game 3. Such a close matchup here between Team Zero and Sweet Slumber J. Definitely deserving of a semi-finals in Westwood right now. The winner will proceed to the grand finals to fight for the top 2 placings. And it's 50,000 gold at stake here. The champion gets 50,000, the second placing gets 25,000. He points the big attack wisely. Architect is going in strong, doesn't care about his HP right now. Holy Bolt, avoided. Going nice, the Shinbreaker on the Magma Wave. Base air evasion nicely. Electric Smite as iframe. Gets caught by the Ice Beam here, but no freeze. Makes Infection to chase. Trying to get the block counters up. Avoids the bubble thankfully. As Ice Pump chasing him. Block counters over, Shinbreaker is good. Lightning Zap cancelled. Shield charge through the wall, base air evasion. Holy Bolt avoided. Oh, it's gonna be close, 72% HP left for Lollydab. Divine Avatar timing here, it's up to Architect taking this away right now. Can he do it? Ejector used, position breaker, nice plays from Lollydab so far. Justice Crash connects here, no Electric Smite. Bits the way attack. Electric Smite after pinning the way attack is good. He's caught, Ice Cut Expansion cancel I believe. Lollydab caught by Holy Bolt right now. Armor Break 5% HP, he's gonna take it for Team Zero, could it be? He takes it for Team Zero! Team Zero goes into the Grand Finals, GG! And Sweet Slava J will fight for 3rd and 4th placing here. And we were just 1 minute before midnight, before the curfew, for the Net Cafe actually strike. So once again, thanks for watching, God bless! And watch out for Matt Xiao versus Matt Chapalang coming up next in the next semi-finals. Thanks for watching once again, God bless, and we'll see you guys next time. Good night and goodbye. Master Mirror matchup at the moment, so we're gonna be seeing... Oh, the ping pong from... Nima is good, I can see Ping Pong damage has been nerfed. Only 15% damage previously, he has been doing a lot. But Nima gets caught by Ping Pong himself. But he has 40% damage taken compared to Dio Sakura's 15%, so he has the advantage. Mind Control is used. Gets caught by the stun grenade here. 2 bar bubble as well. And the Ice Bomb Tower is out. Also the flash grenade. Battle Chemical Missile is good, but you can see Nima Icon once again